Hi, this is Carrie from Curtin Teaching and Learning. In this video, I'm going to show you a few things to help you get started. We'll discuss the role of Turnitin in the HDR process and how to submit your work. As a higher degree by research student, you already have some experiences with the principles of academic writing, including the concepts of paraphrasing to put the ideas of others into your own words, and the importance of acknowledging the work of others using in-text citations and references. In recognition of this prior experience, the process for managing academic integrity in the work of HDR students here at Curtin has been designed to foster a dialogue between the HDR student and their supervisors. To facilitate this dialogue, you have been given access to make submissions to Turnitin in order to generate an originality report that you can then share and discuss with your supervisors as an assurance of the originality of your work and as an indicator of your progress in developing an appropriate academic writing style for your discipline. If you haven't encountered Turnitin in your previous studies, it is important that you understand that Turnitin is a text matching tool that helps ensure that you are appropriately using paraphrasing in your work rather than copying directly from sources. Turnitin is not a plagiarism detection system. Turnitin cannot determine if you have cited or referenced correctly. The results of the Turnitin originality report need to be interpreted carefully. Check out the video Understanding Turnitin's Report for further guidance. Access to Turnitin for HDR students at Curtin is provided within the Research Integrity HDR course in Blackboard. Look for the originality checking link in the menu on the left. Here you will notice some further information about the role of Turnitin in the HDR process, and two folders titled Candidacy and Thesis. Open a folder and you will see the Turnitin icon indicating that this page element contains a Turnitin submission link. When you are ready to submit, click on the View Complete link. Then click on the Submit button. There are a number of steps to the submission process. Your progress is shown here. Start by filling in your details. Notice that your name has automatically been filled in, so all you need to add is the submission title. In the submission title box, it will be helpful if you include the date or file version number with the document title. You can either choose to submit your work by uploading a saved file or by choosing the cut and paste method. If you only have a short piece of text, you can use the cut and paste option, but in general, you will use the file upload option. If you'd like to use the cut and paste upload method, click on this pull-down menu and select the cut and paste option. Paste your text into this box and click the upload button. To use the file upload method, you have three choices for locating your file. You can choose a file stored on your computer, or choose a file stored in Dropbox or Google Drive. Select your file and click Upload. The name of the file you selected is shown here. If you selected the wrong file, click the Clear button and choose the correct file before proceeding. Before you click on the Upload button, be sure to read and understand the student declaration statement. By proceeding to the next step, you are acknowledging that you agree that the work you are submitting is your own. Once your file is uploaded, you will see a preview. Click through the pages to check that you've selected the right file. You can also check and confirm the file properties like the file name, the number of pages, and the word count. Click Confirm to complete the upload process. In the final step of the process, you will receive confirmation that your submission has been completed. You must complete all three steps in the process for your file to be submitted. Click the Return to Assignment List button to return to the assignment inbox. To check your submission and to obtain a receipt as proof of submission, click the View button. At the bottom left, click on the printer icon and choose the middle option, Download PDF of Digital Receipt for Printing. Depending on your browser preferences, this will download the file and open it, or save it in a folder on your computer. Your digital receipt shows the date and time that your file was submitted. The submission ID is the unique identifier for your submission. Should your submission be accidentally removed from this submission point, this ID will allow the submission to be retrieved from the Turnitin database. it is a good idea to keep your digital receipts as you check the various pieces of work you submit through your higher degree by research process. Further information about Turnitin, plagiarism, and academic integrity is available on Curtin's Academic Integrity website. You can easily access the website from inside Blackboard using this tab. Information and useful links for HDR students can be found in the Information for Researchers section of the website. The next video will help you to understand Turnitin's report and the Similarity Index.